नमस्कार एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मल्टीसिम ट्यूटोरियल। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द बेसिक्स ऑफ ऑसिलोस्कोप इन मल्टीसिम। सो लेट्स बिगिन द सेशन। First of all, I'll quickly make a circuit. Now, from this measuring instrument toolbar, we are going to get oscilloscope. So just click and drag oscilloscope over here. So this is the oscilloscope. Let me show you that this is the two terminal of channel A and these are the two terminals of channel B. This is for external trigger. Right now we are not going to use this section. We are focused on this section. Majority of your task is going to be fulfilled using this section. Now we are going to open this scope and we'll see how this scope looks like. So this is the interface of scope. To understand this interface, what we'll do, we'll just connect this scope with this circuit and observe the waveform. So this is the plus terminal. So we are going to connect this plus terminal over here and the minus terminal over here. If you place a separate ground over here and connect this minus terminal to that ground, that is also fine. So now we are measuring ultimately the voltage across these two resistance. So the voltage waveform across these two resistance will be shown over here. So we are going to run this circuit and you can see that the waveforms are appearing on the screen of this CRO, but it is not properly visible. So we will just stop this thing, drag to observe this previous waveforms, and we can see that these waveforms are not properly visible. So to make it properly visible to us, we need to adjust the scale of CRO. So first of all, let me start with the adjustment of scale. This is the section from where we can adjust the scale. This is the time base. That means this horizontal scale per division can be adjusted using this section. Channel A represents whatever quantity you have connected with this channel A. The scale of vertical scale of that quantity, that can be controlled using this section. And whatever quantity you connect with section B, the vertical section or the vertical scale of that quantity can be controlled from here. So let me adjust this scale. Let's increase it. This scale is 50 volt per division. What does this mean? You can see one division vertically. So this is one division. So each division vertically represents 50 volt. Now let me show you horizontal scale. That represents 10 millisecond per division. That means from here to here it is 10 millisecond. So horizontal scale from here to here, that is 10 millisecond. Let me adjust it again. If we increase it, the waveform shrinks, and if you want to expand it, we need to reduce the scale. So now the scale represents 5 millisecond per division. That means from this point to this point, it represents 5 millisecond. So this is how, by adjusting scale, you can appropriately set your waveforms onto the screen of oscilloscope. Now let me show you something else. This section represents the different quantities. Over here, there are two vertical lines When you drag these vertical lines, you can see that the values are changing over here. Over here, it's written T1 and this is T2. So just observe that when I'm changing T2, the values are changing in front of T2. So this horizontal line represents the value of T1 and this horizontal line represents the value of T2. On this line, this is the circle, this is the point which coordinates are mentioned over here. This point, the horizontal scale is 7.371 second and this point vertically is 71.268 volt. So at 7.371 at this point, the magnitude of this waveform is 71.268 volt. So at any particular point, the magnitude of that waveform can be identified from this point. This is line 2. So if you are having two waveforms, that also you can measure from here. And if you want to identify the difference between these two points, that also can be identified from this point. T2 minus T1 represents the time difference between these two points. It's 8.617 millisecond, and the difference between the magnitude of these two points, that is minus 413.203 volt. So observing this thing, you can know various quantities as I have mentioned. This represents reverse. Reverse means by clicking this, you can reverse the background. Sometimes it appears more appropriate when we have white background. So whatever background you are comfortable with, you can adjust it by clicking over here, right? Now let me show you something else. See, the waveform that you are observing right now, the resolution of that waveform can be controlled from here. You just need to go into simulate, interactive simulation setting, click and maximum time step. This maximum time step represents time difference between two consecutive points. So let's just click this. This is 1E minus 005. Let's just do it as 1E minus 001. Okay, and run it again. Stop. Now you can see over here that the resolution of this waveform is changed. That means reading taken per unit time is reduced. Now let me increase that reading taken per unit time, but just keep this non-smoothness in your mind. And now let me just increase this. So we have increased this up to 1E minus 006. Now let's run this thing. So you can observe that reading taken per unit time is increased and see the smoothness of the waveform. So you can see from here that smoothness of waveform can be improved by changing the maximum time step. Now let me show you something else. Now I'm going to show you that how you can change the color of your waveform into the scope. See, over here we are having the red colors of waveform into the scope. So if you have multiple waveform in your scope and if you want to differentiate easily by color, how can you easily differentiate your two waveforms by differentiating in color? So let me show you that. This is the terminal from where you are measuring the quantity, right? This is the positive terminal. So click that positive terminal. Now right click it and click on segment color. On segment color, you have options of various colors. Now just pick any of the color and press OK. So the color of this line is changed. Now double click this, run it again and stop. And you can observe that the color of this segment has been changed. This waveform previously were of red color and now it's of green color. So this is how you can change even the color. So this is what the basic functionality of oscilloscope. In upcoming videos of oscilloscope, we are going to learn that how we are going to measure the voltage and current of any circuit using current probe. So see you into the next session. Bye bye.